Okay, guys, so welcome back to Zombies Challenges, or Zombies, or whatever you want to call them. But today, and for the next few episodes, we're going to be doing one that I found called The Hungry Box. Basically, I can't get a box until round 5. I can use all the perks, I can use wall guns, but every round I have to swap out the gun that I've got from the box and keep it for the rest of the round. So round 5, buy a gun from the box, take it no matter what it is. And then round 6, swap that gun out for whatever gun I get from the box next. Which is it's quite different than the way I usually play. Because usually I go on town, usually save up to get Galva Knuckles. Where's the box? There. Save up to get Galva Knuckles. And then I usually have them by like round 4, round 5, round 6 at the latest. What else? Round 4, round 5, round 6 at the latest. And then they're pretty much sorted because. Welcome back to Stevie's Sister Interrupting While Recording. Best show ever. Where was I? Oh, yeah. And then once you got your Gavin up, because it's like one hit kill until. Round 13's last round is a one hit kill on. And then you can get. You can point haul with pretty much any gun, and then you can just get, this perk up here, Juggernog, fairly easily. And Gout of the Knuckles cancel out explosions, so on this map, it's a kind of bonus. Oh geez, I've got to get used to this kind of sensitivity, because I've been playing a lot of Destiny. Well, to be fair, I've been playing like nothing but Destiny, other than the odd foray into zombies every now and again. Like, I played zombies like twice in the last couple of weeks. And, I played GTA once. Last week. But, oh, for fuck's sake. For the last couple of weeks, I've just been playing Destiny, because it's Destiny. I mean, there are quite a lot of things that they need to fix, like loot drops and engrams, among other things. Oh, jeez. Like, the fact that you still get salvage bounties when salvage isn't even in the playlists anymore. But, yeah. Oh, nice, ammo, nice. Feck. That was embarrassing. I always feel like doing zombies challenges when I've not played zombies in a while. Oh, my days. Right. Take 2. Alright, let's try this again. I think I'll still go for Galva Knuckles. Because that'll just help in the long run. I mean, once I get a box, then obviously I won't be able to use them, but you know, it's. They definitely help in the long run, but anyway. Let's try to do better this time around. That was fairly embarrassing. Alright, the box is still there. Like in Destiny, you don't get this high and this kind of sensitivity. You get like 10. And even that's like. Well, it's not that slow, but. You know, it's still slow. So once you've played on COD sensitivity for a while, then, and vice versa, once you play on Destiny sensitivity for a while. The amount of times I've played this recently, this is the map I've played few times I've played zombies, and I've just gone, explode, yay, explode, yay, explode, yay, then jumped in the lava, and gone down because of it. Or, like, be up there, get hit a couple of times, fall down, not be red screened, but then jump on lava and just die instantly. It's like, GG. Really great game. Enjoy that. That's the stuff I like. Yep. Alright, I can open this door. Never heard that buzzing sound before. I've been playing this map for, what, about a year and a half, and I've never heard that buzzing sound before. Oh, jeez. Completely miss him. Ah, balls. I was hoping that he wouldn't die. Probably should have shot him in the leg, to be honest. God damn it! I was hoping the double points would count before I stab him. So, getting so unlucky with my stuff. Don't know what class it is. Oh, Jesus. 800. That's not too bad, actually. Getting 800 for a nuke right at the end. To be fair, I would have liked to stab that last zombie before getting that nuke, but still. The end of a round, 800, an extra 800 points does not go amiss. This is where point whoring on this map gets really annoying, because lava does actually, like when the zombies are on fire, it does actually burn, damage them, so. It can take, instead of two shots, one shot. It doesn't, I don't think it damages enough to kill them, but, balls. I'm sure that's it, it makes it easier, but, you know. Less points, so. Oh, jeez. Good at a high round, not so good at a low round. Just gonna casually go around preparing barriers now. Get as many points as possible. That point whoring dough. I've got a really sore ankle for some reason. It's like it aches. Oh. I come old and it's like the cold makes my bones ache, kind of achy, like an achy breaky heart. Goal: make 1,370 points in one round, plus another 9. Oh, to be fair, I need to make 950 before the end of that round, so I can buy a gun from the box. And another 950. So I can buy a gun from the box in round 6. I thought that third shot missed him. See? Two shots. Oh, fuck no. Completely forgot that door wasn't open. Okay. Okay. Timing. There you go. Easy. I wasn't worried. Nah, who'd you take me for? A warrior? I'm not a warrior, I'm a warrior. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Actually, putting all these zombies in. I'm definitely gonna have enough to buy a box. Not even a doubt. I'll have enough. Oh, jeez. See? easily. And I'll easily get a box by the end of this round. Or enough for another box at the end of this round. M8. Okay. Not a great gun for point whoring, especially at this lower round. I'm going to get a rape train going. Get more points in. Less wastage. Okay, that'll do. Don't really want insta kill. If I can get enough. Oh, jeez. To buy a jug and another box. That's great. Yeah, I'll have enough. Alright, so quickly work it out. Maybe not then. Completely forgot about that door. Again, for the second time in this game. Come on, give me a gun. God damn it. Not helpful. God, the M1216. That'll be fun. Right, now checks, here we go. Oh boy. I'll get enough to make a get another box. But I don't know if I'll get enough to get a juggernaut as well. I've opened the door, so I won't have to worry about that. I know I've opened the door this time. Let's try and get a little bit of a rate drink going here. Ring a ring a roses, a pocket full. You're cheating. The posies. You're definitely cheating. Okay, yep. Now we go up the stairs. Oppa! Shit, reload. Oh shit, no. Fuck. And that's the last zombie, so not enough to buy jug yet. God damn! Bit of a pain in the ass. Got to be joking. Wall gun, I guess it is for me. Go buy the MP5. Won't even count because I've got the Galvan knuckles. Let me buy it. Thank you. Ah, double pointer. Round 8, and still don't have a jug. Whoop, whoop. Right. I hate play. Like, this is one of my favourite maps just because it's, you know, it's a basic survival map. You don't have to do anything special, really, to survive. Like, on Die Rise, you need to turn on the power. Die Rise Transit. Buried, you have to turn on the power, and you've got to do all this. And then you've got Origins, because you've got to... You've got to turn on all the different generators, and yes, simple. Get kills, open doors, get perks. Oh, missed that shot. Shit. And missed that shot. Oh. Watch someone come up behind me and windmill me now. That's what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting to get windmilled from behind. Ah, oh, shit. On the upside, I can now buy Juggernog. I now have enough to buy Juggernog. Ah, great. I was thinking it would give me an RPG. To be fair, it's still a one-hit... Oh, majorly one-hit kill at the moment. Throughout the entirety of since round... Oh, jeez. Risky. Risky moves! Since round 5, I've been trying not to use my Galvan Knuckles, but with this, I think... I will use my Galvan Knuckles purely because. The fact it's an RPG. And without Speed Cola, it reloads like shit. Speaking of which, I need to open that up. So now all of the doors are open. Oh shit, Jesus. I got caught on... What even is that? I don't even know. I got caught on the thing. Like crawlers everywhere. I think that's the last one. Let's go get a new gun. Alright, okay. Come on, give me something at least half decent, please. Nah. Not too bad. Wasn't that somebody? There's no crawler. Damn it. Up, 2, 3. Opa! Please get it. No miss, god damn it. 1, 2, 3. Opa! There we go. Second shot's the charm. Second time's the charm. I got a really itchy neck. Right, here they come. To be fair, one thing I don't like about the FM foul, this one, is the reload, at least in this game. Look. That would reload most guns in this game, but not this one. Oh, thank you, Treyarch, for that. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Like, so appreciative. Nope. I'm assuming that grenades allowed because, you know, Semtex is because, you know, the fact that they're technically war weapons. Oh shit, I haven't reloaded. Because of this crappy reload mechanic on this gun. Like, purely this gun that the reload is crap on. I mean, ah, balls. I didn't realize that was. To be fair, I should have realized, but I didn't realize that was the last of the round, last zombie, or the end of the round. Except I mixed both of those phrases up and said the last of the round. Oh yes, thank you. Finally, half decent gun. Should probably buy a double tap as well. Hello. No, not today. No. Ow. Leave me alone. I don't want to get butt stabbed. No. Ah. Oh, where was the red screen? Okay, so when I said at the start of the video, the next few episodes, I did assume that the first and second take weren't going to be so terrible. But I hope you've enjoyed this rather terrible video. It lasted longer than last in the first room challenges, so you know. But yeah, hope you've enjoyed it. I haven't really, because that was really bad for me. But yeah, don't forget to tune in on Thursday for the next Zombies Challenge video, and I'll see you then. Peace.